Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We do the following seven problems on this video. So remember, here's the definition for an even function. It's even if for every x in the domain, negative x is also in the domain, and f of negative x equals f of x. In other words, when you replace x with negative x, your y value is the same, basically. You get the same function. So this means for every ordered pair xy on the graph, the ordered pair negative xy is also on the graph, and it's symmetric with the y-axis. And then we've got the definition of an odd function. Starts out the same. If there's an x in the domain, negative x must also be in the domain, and f of negative x, though, is negative f of x. You get the opposite value of the function. So this means that for every order pair xy on the graph, there's another order pair negative x, negative y that's also on the graph, and this means it's symmetric with the origin. Right, so here's our first problem. Go ahead and put it on pause and see if you can answer this by yourself first. Right, so what we want to do is find out what f of negative x is, right? In every case, to tell if something's even or odd, we'll plug in f of negative x to begin with. So we plug in negative x in place of x and simplify. Oops, that's a minus sign still. Now, because a negative x to the fourth power is just x to the fourth, and a negative x to the second power is just an x squared. So we've simplified this, and the question is this: is this the same function or is it the opposite of the original function? And in this case, it's the same function, right? So f of negative x, if you want to finish it off, you could say, oh, that's actually equal to f of x. So therefore, it's an even function, and that means it's symmetric with the y-axis. So if you look at it, if you look to the right of the y, if you graph this, if there's an ordered pair on the right side of the y-axis, there's a corresponding one on the left side of the x-axis, straight across. Right, here's the next problem, so go ahead and try this on your own. We begin the same way. We want to figure out what f of negative x is. So we replace each x with negative x and simplify. Right, so we have a negative x to the fifth power, that's negative x to the fifth. Now, this negative x cubed is the same thing as negative x cubed, and I've got a minus 4x. So if I keep going here, a negative times a negative, that's a plus 3x cubed minus 4x. All right, so the first question, is that exactly the same as the original function? No. Because I have an x to the fifth here and I have a negative x to the fifth for f of negative x. So the second question is it the opposite? In other words, is it negative f of x? In other words, are all the terms exactly the opposite sign of the original function? And yes, it is, because I have an x to the fifth here, I've got a negative x to the fifth, here I have a negative 3x cubed, here I have a plus 3x cubed. Here I have a plus 4x, here I have a minus 4x. So this is going to be an odd function. So it's symmetric with the origin. Now, if you want, you can go one more step and say, oh, I can write that as the opposite of x to the fifth minus 3x cubed plus 4x. This is a formal way of finishing off the problem. And then you've really written that f of negative x is the same as negative f of x. So again, therefore, that's why it's an odd function and symmetric with the origin. Right, here's our third problem. F of x equals square root of x. This is a little bit tricky. So remember, to be an even or odd function, it means for if there's an x in the domain, negative x is also in the domain. But with the square root function, you can only put positive numbers underneath the square root. So x has to be greater than 0. That's the domain. Actually, it's greater than or equal to 0, right? Or interval notation, that's 0 to infinity, right? So if 5 is in the domain, is negative 5 in the domain? No, you can't graph the square root of negative 1. So there's no point in trying to plug in f of negative x if you just think it through. And this is neither. Okay, so it's not even or odd. If you didn't think about it and you just tried to plug it in, it gets a little bit tricky. You have to think, is that the same function as this? No, it's not, because I have a minus x, and also, is it the opposite? And actually, it's also not the opposite. It's a little bit tricky because without knowing whether x is positive or negative, it's hard to determine out what square root of negative x really means anyway. So in any case, this is a tricky one with square roots, and mainly just one of the main points is that the domain here, x has to be greater than or equal to 0. So if x is positive, then negative x is going to be negative and it'll be neither. All right, here's the next one. Why don't you try to figure this one out? Okay, so we're going to plug in f of negative x. All right, so we're going to plug in negative x for x. And the question, does that give you the same thing? And it doesn't. Now, if you're not sure, you could just square each of these and then it'll be more obvious. So if I take my original function and I square it, I get x squared minus 6x plus 9. If you take negative x minus 3 and square it, this is tricky. You get x squared, okay, but then it's ending up going to be plus 6x plus 9. If you don't see that, just go ahead and write it out this way. You do the FOIL method, x squared, but notice what happens. Negative x times negative 3 is plus 3x, and another plus 3x. Then you have plus 9. So that's where this comes from. So notice these are not the same function, right? They're not exactly the same because I have a minus 6x here and a plus 6x here. And they're also not, the opposite of one of the other because here the x squared terms are the same, but the x terms are not. So for this function up here, it's neither. Now, when it's neither, we don't say it's symmetric with the y-axis or the x-axis. All right, here's our next one. Why don't you go ahead and try that? So we find out what f of negative x is. All right, by replacing x with negative x. So negative x to the third power is just negative x cubed. So that's negative 2x cubed minus 7. And so the question is that exactly the same as f of x? No, it's not, because I have a 2x cubed and a minus 2x cubed. Is it the opposite? Well, it's true that I have a 2x cubed and a minus 2x cubed, but I do not have a minus 7 and a plus 7. These are the same. So it's neither. All right, here's our next one. F of x equals x over x squared minus 1. So try that. So we're going to plug in negative x in place of x. So I have a negative x in the numerator, but the denominator is an x squared minus 1. So what does that mean? So the first thing, is that the same as the original function? That's not true. But is it the opposite of it? In other words, if you factor out a minus sign, you have x over x squared minus 1. Actually, it is the opposite. F of x. So this is an odd function. So it's symmetric with the origin. All right, here's our next example. So Feel free to put the video on pause and try it on your own first. So we're going to plug in negative x in place of x. And then compare to the original function. And that's the same as the original function, right? So that means it's even, which means it's symmetric with the y-axis. Now, the reason we're answering this question about whether it's symmetric with the y-axis is because let's say you were asked to graph this function. Now, you could think of that as y equals 2 over x squared minus 3. All you would have to do is put in positive values for x and figure out your y's, and then you would just have twice as many order pairs on the left-hand side, just putting in the negative values for x and keeping the same values for y. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.